I think it's the jazz people who have been influenced by the classical composers. Today, even as early as the late 40s and 50s, the jazz players all were very heavy influenced by Bartok, Stravinsky, Ravel. And I think that came first. Ravel, I think, was one of the first to become really influenced by the jazz people.
Not to mention that Jimmy Ura, who was the captain of the 359th Infantry Hellfighters jazz band, comes back from France with all kinds of new ideas. The song, How Are You Gonna Keep Them Down on the Farm, after they've seen Paris, was first recorded by his drum major, Noble Sissel, because they were blown away by the reception, and it allowed them, I think, to just say, oh, we're real hot stuff.
I'd like to comment, the French must have had some inclination of the sounds. These are all made in France. They're the best saxophones and clarinets in the world, and they're made in France. And all my reeds are made in France. I mean, three different brands, they say France on the back of them. So they went for that kind of sound, which the Americans developed into jazz. But they're all French instruments. They make the best in the world.
And then talk about the Jewish influence, the clarinet coming in from the klezmer bands. In Tin Pan Alley, you have all these Jewish composers, Irving Berlin, and Gershwin, who are writing in tonalities that are very Middle Eastern, and via Europe, and creating and then mixing it with the rhythmic structures, the call and response, the improvisation that comes from the blues and the spirituals and the other African-American music. And this melding, I think what's so interesting is exactly what you were talking about in terms of the Italian. It keeps going. It keeps melding back and forth. And you never know, where's one influence start and the other end. And it really doesn't matter because it's just kind of a big pot and we all get to partake. So, for my first album, I had recorded Les Berceaux, just in a string arrangement, straight classical kind of arrangement. But I always was looking for ways to bring Faure into my cabaret shows because I specialized in la chanson française. So for my third album, Romance Language, I wanted to sing Lydia, but the album was very jazzy and needed something different. And my bass player and the guitarist and I tried to figure out how to make it a bossa nova. And it worked so well that other people, said, oh, it's their favorite song on the album, whatever. And I thought, well, if we can do that, we should certainly be able to do other songs by Faure. I was somewhat inspired also by Yves Montand because he made a recording of Les Berceaux. It's quite ethereal. He sings it a cappella through almost the entire thing. Then he sings, there's an ethereal choir that comes in for a little piece of it. And that was, I'm going, wow, if he can, this popular singer, like he gives a call, if he can do Les Berceaux, we ought to be able to do things like that. So I thought I would just take a little look at Lydia, just to show them what we did with Lydia.
Thank you. Quelques degrés en plus, ce qui lasse, sans se lasser, sentir l'amour devant tout ce qui passe, ne point passer.
Voilà. I'm going to tell you what it is. We're sitting here by the banks of the water, the two of us watching everything pass by without passing. And we see in the clouds the clouds that are sliding by. We let them slide by. And in the horizon, we see the smoke coming from the chimney. We watch it smoke. And if we have at the horizon, the flowers that are blooming, we surround ourselves in the bloom. Mm-hmm. And we listen to the water murmuring by the weeping willow. And having no care for the world except that we adore each other. Mm. And as everything goes by, we don't go by. Mm. We feel everything passing, but we never pass. We stay.
Very nice. Yes.